Okay, good morning. So yesterday we were discussing admin panel, WordPress admin panel. Okay, just let me get into WordPress admin panel. Yesterday we were changing the yesterday we were adding a post items, and we changed it to another theme. So today also we discuss some more in this website. So yesterday we discussed themes and customers, and then we were at widgets. So just go to appearance, and then the appearance, click on the widgets. Here we can see available widgets. So they will provide you, they are providing when you install the theme or that particular theme, what are the widgets are supported by theme. Those themes will be available here. Those widgets will be given here. So we can see here available widgets. To activate a widget, drag it to a sidebar or click on it. So to deactivate a widget and delete its settings, drag it back. So if you want to activate any available widget, so just you can drag and drop the on particular this kind of on main size main sidebar or home page sidebar or anywhere. If you want to drag this, if you want to make the widget available in any area, just drag and drop. Otherwise, you can double click on that and select the particular area. So like that. This is their widget. Just a second. So archives is one of the widgets. Audio is one of the widgets. Calendar, categories, custom HTML, gallery, image. So magazine prime author widgets, and some magazine prime popular post, and a magazine prime sidebar tab, style one, style two, meta. So these are all the available widgets. So up to video we have. These are all the available widgets. So if I want to add, so I want to add archives to my site. So what I will do, just I will drag this one and I just drop here like this. So, and then what I do, I just give the titles to the particular widget, archives. So display as a drop down, you want the archives as a drop down, or show post counts you want. Just you can click anyone, just click on the save. So where it is going to show? It is going to show on the main sidebar. Main sidebar means this one. This one is the this part, the right side of the part. This is the main sidebar of the website. So here it is going to show. It is going to show the archives. So actually we have this kind of we will have separate sections of our website. So like main sidebar and home page sidebar one, home page sidebar two, footer column one, column two, column three. On this particular for this theme, we have this many kind of sections in our website. Sections means if you take example, just so I'm clicking on home page. If you think this is a home page, so this is one of the section. This is one section, and this one is one section, and this footer is one section, and this main area, main text area, this posting area, this is one section. So like this, we will have some sections. The website will be divided as the sections. So like that, we will have for our theme. So our theme name is what? Just a second. Our theme name is Maxim Prime. So it's a free theme. So as we discussed, free themes will have some limitations because they are providing us freely, but they have given you this kind of options. Because it's a free theme, they have given you these many sections. If you are here, if you buy premium theme, if you buy a theme, then you will get many options. You will get many widgets here. So this, as this is a free theme, they are providing you only only a few widgets and a few sections. So if you buy premium theme, you will get many widgets available. You will get many widgets and you will have many sections also. That's where if you have many widgets, if you have many sections, then you can easily customize the website. You can easily, with fingertips, you can customize according to your requirement. If you don't have much options, so then you don't have that much. Now you cannot customize that much how according to your requirement, you cannot customize. Whatever the available widgets are available, whatever the available sections are, just you can do with the particular widgets only. So we added that one, right? We added archives, right? So just I'm refreshing. See here, archives. So it's showing you archives and select month. So if you want April 2018 archives, just click on April 2018 archives. So we have only one post, right? So yesterday only we have posted one article. So it shows you all the articles which are posted in April particular month. So you can get the archives like this. So just I am deleting. I don't want archives here. So if you don't want that particular ad widget, just click on the cancel button or delete button. So whatever the archives, whatever the widget you want, just you can go here. So actually in my main sidebar we have search widget, recent posts, recent comments, archives already here, categories and meta. And homepage sidebar here we don't have any widgets in this homepage sidebar too. Here also we don't have any. In footer you will see no widget is there. In here also no widget is there. Footer column 3, column 1, column 2, column 3 means in footer is divided into 3 columns. Just I will show you here. This is a footer, so it is, the footer is divided into 3 columns, like up to here one column, and up to here one column, and up to here one column. So 3 columns were divided in this widget, in this particular theme. So just and main sidebar one, this home page sidebar one, sidebar two means when you click on the particular article, just we will check whether where this one will appear. So what I will do, just what are this magazine prime author, display author details in the post. So if you want the author details in the post, you can use this widget. So magazine prime popular post, this is nothing but displays post from selected category specific for popular post in sidebar. So if you want to get your popular post, so then you can use this widget. So just you can double click on this one. Otherwise, if you double click on that particular widget, so you will get options. So where to add, where on particular, if you want to add in main sidebar or homepage sidebar one, so homepage sidebar two or footer column or anywhere. So just if you I will select my homepage sidebar one and add widget. Here directly it comes to that homepage sidebar one. Here you have to give title. So then just I'm giving title as popular post. and I have to select a category. As I have created only one category, just clicking on one category, number of posts, how many posts you want on that particular widget. So select the number of posts. You can select any number of posts, 5, 6, it's your wish. Click on the save button. Let us see where this particular widget will come. Okay, so I'm clicking on particular item. Actually, we have to get the widget in the homepage sidebar one, but just a second, we will check what. Okay, let's add this one in main slide bar. Just I will add here. Okay, save. Just to check. See, a popular post came here. Trying to pick table to run it in. Will ban go past some article. Only one article is there, so that's why it is showing only one. So, but in sidebar one also it has to come, but where it is coming, just we have to check. We will check that one also. No need to worry. So then, like that, according to our requirement, according to our business, according to our whatever the what are the articles you write, what is your website is about. So then, according to your requirement, you can do the customization. So just what are the other widgets are available? Just we will see. This is sidebar tab, so that means this is tabbed widget. That means you will get some sidebars on the particular tab. So prime style one, that means displays post from selected category in grid. So it shows you that selected a particular post in the grid. In the grid format, it shows you. So and even displays post from selected category on list format. So if you want to get the particular post in the list format, then you can use this particular widget. And meta means whatever the that meta details of that particular website, RSS and WordPress links, RSS links and login details. So see everything. If you want, you can use this. So navigation menu. So some navigation they will show you. So home, from home, if you click on cinema, they will show you home cinema, and then if you click on any article, then they will show you home cinema article. So like that, they will give you navigation pages. So here a list of your site's pages they will show you. If you want to show the pages, so then they will show you pages. So what we will do one thing, we will add pages in the footer column one. We will add pages. Here I will give about us. Actually, we have already created one page, right? So just I'm going to that page, about us page we have already created. Just click on edit. So we will have some page ID. So what is the page ID of this particular here we can see here a permalink. So here page ID is appearing, right? So page ID is nothing but what is this page ID? 10. So just I'm going to add page ID. Just I will give 10. What will happen, whether the about us is show here or not? Sample page it is showing. Okay. Just a second. Page title I will give about us. Okay, so then I'm refreshing. See, we got about us. Just click on about us. We got about us pages. So actually these pages, whatever the pages we create, we should not add them in the this menu bar. So because this should be somewhere else, so that about us and disclaimer, privacy policy, so everything we can add the over here. You can add in the footer, or even you can add it at the top of the website also, at the top of the header here also you can add. That's your wish. So according to the changes, as it is a free thing, you cannot do all the changes. So as I said, just we have taken as an example of this theme. So we cannot do all the changes. So according to what are the changes are available in the website, on the particular admin panel, just we can take the those changes only. We can do. So just we will see. So like that, we have footer column 2, column 3 also. In footer column 2, what we will do, just we will add categories. We will add. See whether categories option widget is there or not. Yeah, categories widget is available. Just drag the widget and drop the widget here. So you want to just give the title of the particular widget. So categories I am giving. And if you want the categories as a display as drop down, you want the drop down list of categories, or show post counts you want, or show hierarchy you want. So just I'm giving the option of display as the drop down. So let's see what happens. See categories. Select the categories. So you can select the category cinema, and then you will get the all the category related articles you will get here. So even we will create another categories also today. So like that, you can do the customization in the in this kind of in this widget bar. So Okay, so then we will move to menus. Click on menus. Just a second. Okay, menus. So if you want any extra widgets, so if you want particular, if you have particular requirement, so if you don't have any what is the required widgets, if you don't have in this particular available widgets, then we can go for the extra widgets. So that is nothing but in the name of plugins, with the help of plugins we can get the our required widgets, so that we will discuss next. Okay, so that we will discuss in the plugin topic. Okay, so next, menus. So menus we already discussed. So we have to we can create here create a new menu, and then we have to add the categories in the particular menu. So actually about us we already added in the footer, so that's why here I'm removing this one. So just we have to add the categories, whatever the categories you create, just you add the categories here. So just I'm creating the some more categories here. So cinema, and then I'm creating just I create outbeat. So then I give slug also outbeat. So there is no parent. So this category is about upbeat news. So upbeat news means any new, any different news like that. Those are called upbeat news. So clicking the new category. So I created another category, and then I try to create another one also. Just photo gallery. I'm creating one category. Slug also. Photo underscore gallery. So we should not give any space here. So no parent category. Then give the description. This category is about photo gallery. Okay. Add new category. And then I create another category also, video gallery. So any name according to your business, according to your website, what your website deals with. So then you create the categories. Video categories, parent category, no? Description. This description also optional. If you give also, if you don't give also, no issue. It will create you directly. You don't need to worry. And I will give technology or tech news. I will give tech news. Slug also tech underscore slug. I will give technology. Okay. This category deals with technology news. Click on the add new category. Okay, and then I create some politics. So slug political, same politics use slug. So this category deals with politics news, not political news. A new category. So like that you can create any number of categories. There is no restriction that you have to create only these many categories. No, you can create any number of categories. And then I'm moving to, I'm closing this one. Okay, this one also I'm closing. So here what we have to do, just I'm refreshing this one. So here, categories, just click on the category one. So view all, So what are the categories we have created right now? All the categories are showing here. So here cinema already we have created. So now you have created orbit, photo gallery, politics, tech news and video gallery. Just select the categories, whatever the categories you want to add to the menu, just select the and check the box, then click on the add to menu. See here, you got the all the categories here. So about us we have deleted it. About us remove. So then you have got all the categories here. So just click on the save menu. Let's see here what happens in the front side. Just click on the refresh. See here, cinema, orbit, photo gallery, politics, tech news, video gallery. And even you can get another, we have some more space also here you can get. If you want to have some more category also, you can add. This one is popular news. So you got popular news. So okay, popular news you got here. See here. So popular news you got here. Have you seen? Okay. Like this also, you can get popular news here. So what I will do, so if you click on the particular category, you will get the all the articles related to another particular category. Actually, we have not added any articles in this category. So if you click on the upbeat, you will not get any articles because we have not added any article on a particular category since we can't find what you're looking for. So like the, if you click on the particular category, you will get all the category related articles here. Same way, politics. So if you want to rearrange the particular category, so you don't want cinema first. So actually you want, first you want home, and then in every website, if you just see any website, just, what are the entertainment websites? Just we will see Great Andhra only. If you check the Great Andhra on the first category of the menu bar is nothing but it will be home. So that means it's a home is a starting page. As we discussed yesterday, it's a starting page. So definitely you have to when you click on the home, you will get the first home page as a starting page. So what I want, so first I want home. So but we want home as a page, not as a category. So what you will do, just I'm going to pages, create the add new, and then get the home. Click on the publish. So just you have I will go here and click on the pages. So just refresh. Home we got it. In pages click on the same pages also, we can drag and drop like this only. Just select the home, add to menu. So it was added here. Click on the save menu. Just check what will happen. Yeah, home came here, but at the last of the categories, it was added. But if you see live example where home was there, it was at the first of the category. So then what we have to do, we have to rearrange the category. So how we can rearrange the categories? Let's see now. Just you select the particular category, and then just move with the mouse bar, just like this. You drag the button and then paste wherever you want. Just open, just release the mouse button like this. So if you want politics as a after cinema, you want politics, just drag the politics and drop here. So you want tech news after orbit, just drag it and drop it. Photo gallery, video gallery, like this you want categories. So then click on the save menu. Let's see what happens. See here, home, cinema, politics, object, techniques, photo gallery, you got it right. So if you click on the home, what will happen? Nothing will happen because we have not yet created any home page, right? We have not yet created any home page. So static home page we have to create. So we have not yet created that, we will see later. So if you create some static page, static home page, then if you click on the home, you will get the static home page. So when you click on the other categories, you will get the all the articles related to categories. So then when you want to come to home, you can click on the home like this. So when you click on the particular logo, how you are getting, so this is the latest post we are getting. So actually we have to create the static home page, so that also we will discuss. So then, so I hope you understood the menus. So if you want to add even custom links also, you can add. That means any link, if you want to give the link to any particular item or any particular website, then you can give the custom links also here, and you can add the particular custom links to the menu bar. So like this, I will show you just a second. So what I will do, just we will take Create Andhra only. Just copy the URL, paste it in the option of URL, and giving link text to Create Andhra, add to menu. So Create Andhra came to the added in the menu structure, and then I'm clicking on the save menu. So what will happen, just see, refresh the website. You see here, after video gallery, what was added? Create Andhra was added. So if you have any some other website, so not only this website, you have some subsidiary websites to this particular website, or if you have any other business related website, if you want your customer or if you want your user to redirect to that particular websites, then you can give the links here. So when the user click on that particular Create Andhra, he will be redirected to Create Andhra website. So like that. So when you click on this one, he will be redirected to that particular website. So if you want your customer to redirect to any other websites which are belongs to you, or which are other businesses, if you have any other business, if you have any websites, so if you want them to redirect, then give the any custom link here. So like that, you can use the custom link. So just I am deleting that one. Save menu. So here, so pages we understood. We have already discussed pages and posts also we discussed, and custom links also posts we have not yet discussed. So if you want any post to be added in the menu structure, then you can add the post also here. So this one, so even custom links we discussed, and categories also we discussed. Okay, this is the concept of menu. If you want to create another menu also, you can create just clicking on the create new menu, and you can create another menu also. Main menu work, just I am clicking main menu work, click on the create menu, you will get another menu also. So like that, you will get. So if you want to create subcategories also, so like the, when we see, just I will show you any subcategories are there. Just a second, we'll go to national websites. See here, if I place the mouse on the particular category of business, then what it's showing? Agribusiness, industry, economy, markets, budget, and stakeholders. When I want to have this kind of subcategories, what I have to do. Just we will see. First we have to create the categories. Just I am clicking on the categories option. Then in cinema we create some subcategories. So like Telugu cinema. Slug is Telugu cinema, or it's better to give Tollywood. Now, most of the people will call it as a Tollywood, right? Okay. Tollywood. Here, parent category is required. So, who is your parent? So, in which category you want to create these subcategories? So, definitely on the cinema. Just so click the cinema as your parent category, and then click the description. You can give this subcategory is exclusively about Tollywood news. Anything you can give, and click on the add category. So then also we will give Kollywood. Kollywood means it's a Tamil industry. So Kollywood. Same parent category, cinema. This category is about Tamil cinema news. Click on add new category. And what are the other words? Bollywood, right? Bollywood. Bollywood. This category is about Bollywood Hindi movies news. Click on the add category. And what are the other words are there? Sandalwood. Sandalwood, right? So what is Sandalwood? It's about Kannada industry, right? Okay, this category is about Kannada movies news. And what are the other categories? We have Mollywood. Mollywood is for Malayalam. So I'm just clicking on this category is about. So we have to create categories, each and every category you have to prepare. So you have to work on the categories before only, before creating all the categories, you have to work on the categories. What category is best for you, or what, how many subcategories you want to create, how many categories you want to create. So everything you have to study, you have to analyze, and then you have to finalize the categories before only. So this category is about Malayalam movies news. So what are the other famous Hollywood. This category is about Hollywood movies news. Okay. Just click on the any category. So how many subcategories we have created in the particular cinema? So Hollywood, Mollywood, Sandalwood, Bollywood, Kollywood, and Tollywood. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many? 6 categories we have created. So just what I'm doing, I'm going to appearance menus, and then I will click on the, so where we are, so actually we have selected main menu 1. So we are in the, we have actually main menu, right? Click on the main menu and select, and then click on the categories option, and then view all, and then select the all the categories. Click on add to menu. You see here, all the categories are added to the main menu. You just click on the save menu. What will happen? Just we will see what will happen. See here. So it was It was crossed, so this menu bar was completed, and the menu bar was crossed, so that's why it expanded. The menu bar was expanded and it was extended to second line. So Bollywood, Hollywood, Hollywood, Mollywood, Sandalwood, Tollywood. So Tollywood spelling correct? Just a second. Tollywood or Tollywood? I have a doubt. Okay, Tollywood only. Okay, so here what is happening? So even you have added the subcategories as you were as a in the cinema category, but you have not added in the subcategory of cinema in the menu bar. So that's why it is showing all them as a categories. So but what you have to do here, just you have to rearrange the categories. Like first you want Tollywood, right? Tollywood is more preferred because just drag and drop like this. So just you have to give some gap to the category and subcategory, then it will understand that okay, so this is category and this is subcategory. It will the people this admin or this particular website will think that okay, this is category and this is subcategory. So and then after then what is the important one? Okay, Bollywood. Same, this one also give like this. So give some gap to the category and then drag and drop same. All the other subcategories also do the same. So just you drag like this and drop. And another one, Hollywood. And Mollywood. And then Sandalwood. Just click on the save menu. Let's see what happens. Click on the refresh. So they are gone, right? So click on the cinema. See here, Tollywood, Bollywood, Collywood, Hollywood, Collywood, Mollywood, Sandalwood. You got the menu subcategories like this, right? So like this, you can get the sub menu also like this. If you click on the Tollywood, you will get the articles related to Tollywood. So but right now we don't have any articles on the Tollywood, right? Okay. So then you will move to header. So just click on the header. So what will be, so header means if you open the website, so this part is called header. So before when you see the menu bar, so before the after the menu bar, so when you this is menu bar, this menu bar divides web page like this. So header and then menu bar and then this home page. So this is called as header and this is menu bar and this is total home page. So then where the logo is available and this particular space is available, this one is called header. So if you want to do any changes in the header, so then you can do the changes by using this concept. So here they are asking you, so this one also actually here header means they are calling this one is also a header in this particular theme. So actually header is nothing but in most of the in most of the themes or in most of the websites, just I will show you, this one is called header. So only this part is called header up to here. So from here to icons, from social media icons to this part is called header. But here as per the theme requirements, they are saying up to here is the header option. So then if you want to change any things from this kind of place, then you can do with the header option. So if you want to add any header image, there they are giving you option to select the header image. If you want to add, just click on the add new and then you can okay, just we will give this one for just for testing purpose we will give. Okay, just crop image. See here, we got the header image. So if you want to give any your company related image, if you have any your company logo or your company building image or any image you want to give, just you give the image as your header image. So this is the banner title. So this title will only appear on latest post selection. So if you want to give the banner title, they are asking you to give the banner title of the particular website. So what is banner title? Just when you click on the, when just show, just go to on the top of the address bar of your web browser, like here, and just place the your okay, just a second. Okay, we are not saved, right? Click on the publish. Okay, so here you got the image, and what we are asking, they are saying welcome to Magazine Prime. So they are saying that welcome to Magazine Prime. So then if you want to change this text, then you can text the this banner, particular banner title. So like the, okay, just I'm typing the website name and then clicking on the publish. Just refresh. See here, welcome to Vagulkar. Just like that, you will get the particular this header image you can change. Okay, and then I'm moving to in the appearance, then background. So then if you want to change the background, then you can change the background in that option. Just click on the background. If you want to select any background image, so what I will do, just check for the background images. So I want the this kind of background image. Okay, just I will save the image. Okay, I will select the image from the desktop. Open. Choose image. Just click on the publish. What will happen? We will see. So first, if it has a white color background, right? See here, white color background, we can see here. Just refreshing the website. See here, you got background image as it, this one. Whatever the background image you have chosen, that one you will get. So like that, you will get. So if you don't like this one, just actually most of the websites are looking background color. Their background color is like this light cement color, I think. So this one is okay. Even we can have white color background is also good. Just what I do, just remove the background image. Publish. Just refresh the website. You got the background image. Okay, so then what are the other topics about magazine print? We already discussed. So if you want to know anything about the this theme documentation, you can just go to this option and then you can see all the details of this documentation, theme documentation. You can see if you want to create custom homepage and other than blog listing, you need to create and set a static front page. So how to set static front page? Just if you want to know, you can just click on the static front page and you can do how to do all those static page and everything. So if you want to, know the theme options, theme users, customized API for theme options. So if you want to know the customized options in the theme, just you can click on the this customized option and you will get all the details which are related to the customized option. We already discussed these things in the yesterday's class only. So if you want widgets, Magazine Prime is a widget based theme. That means it has already pre-designed custom additional layout. So if you want demo content, then you can even give the demo content also. We will see even demo content also. Theme preview, if you want to see the theme preview, so everything regarding this particular Magazine Prime theme you can get here. Okay, so you can choose what's displayed on the home page of your site. It can be post in reverse chronological order or a fixed static page. If you want static page or if you want a all the latest posts, if you want, they are asking. So if you click on the static page, so you have to create the static page first. So but we have not yet created static page, so just we have created home, but we have not yet created the post page. So for that we have to create the post page, right? So then we will discuss this one also, but it takes some time. Okay, after discussing all the options which are available, then we will go to that static page also. Okay, so like that you can do. Then install plugins. So just click on the install plugins. So what are the plugins are installed when you click the when you install the WordPress? So what is plugin? Actually, before discussing plugin topic, so we have to discuss something about plugin. So what is plugin? So actually, you have already, when you install this WordPress theme, you will be given enough resources to this website, so which you can customize. But if you want extra functionality, so you want some extra slider, you want some slider option in the website, or if you want some image gallery you want, or video gallery you want, so then what happens? So if you don't have that facility in your theme, so then you have to take the extra functionality, you have to add the extra functionality to the website. So in those cases we use the plugins in order to get the extra functionality of that particular website. So like that, if I want some image gallery, so then image gallery plugins will be available in the WordPress, so then I can just install that particular image gallery plugin, and then I can use that particular plugin anywhere in my website, and then simply I can do the customization. So like that, there are plenty of plugins are available in the WordPress. So just we will see here. So actually, when you are installing the WordPress, only one click demo import one plugin was installed. So here, just click on the all. One plugin was installed. Just see here. So this was also not installed, I think. So they are asking you to install. So you have to. This is a required plugin. When you are installing the WordPress theme only, they will ask you to install some of the important plugins. If any important plugins are available, then they will ask you to install the important plugins. So downloading the installation package unpacking, installing and successfully installed the plugin. So just click on the install plugins. So it was installed, but it was not yet activated. So just click on the activate. Okay, your plugin was activated. So here is the plugin option available. What are the installed plugins? If you want to install a new plugin, then you can click on the add new. If you want any that particular code related data, if you want to see, just you can click on the editor. So before going to plugin, just we will see another option is available here, editor. Just click on the editor. What's they are saying, we appear to be making direct edits to your theme in the WordPress dashboard. So we recommend that you don't. Editing your theme directly could break your site and your changes may be lost in future updates. So if you need to tweak more than your theme CSS, you might want to try making a child theme. If you decide to go ahead with the direct edits anyway, use a file manager to create a copy with a new name and hang on to the original. So that's why you can re-enable a functional version if something goes wrong. What they are saying, so this is the editor, means directly it will be redirected to the particular programming, the code of the particular website will be given. The code will be accessed to you as the admin people. You can access, you will have each and every feature. You can access each and every feature in the admin panel. So that's where if you want to change any code, if you have any knowledge on PHP, if you have knowledge on HTML or CSS or JavaScript, so then definitely you can click on the editor option and then you can go to that code. On the particular code, you can change the option if you know the coding only. So what they are saying, they are also warning us that you appear to be making direct edits to your thing. You are directly going to the editor, and if you want to do the changes, don't do the changes directly. You take the backup first and then do the changes. Why they are saying, if something goes wrong, so definitely you cannot again backup the data. That website may be lost. If something goes wrong, definitely your website may crash, or your website may lead to wrong directions, and it may not show particular and appropriate web pages. So that's where if something goes wrong, so before going to edit the code, so just you take the backup of that particular code, or you otherwise you want to try, just you can make a child theme. We can also make a child theme, and then we can do the changes in the particular we are not doing any. I want to show you just code, so that's where I'm giving you. Otherwise you can in the server, you go to the server, and in the file manager you create a one copy, and that means you copy the all the files which are available in your server, then you copy, or you take the backup of that particular files in the file manager, and you can do the things. If something goes wrong, just you can reapply the all the whatever the backup is there available, just you can reapply the particular backup things into the file manager, and you can get the website. So as we are not doing any changes here, just I understand. Then you can see here, so right side of that particular website, on this right side you can see theme files, style sheet, style.css one file is there, and theme functions. You can just click on the theme functions, you will get theme functions.php, functions.php, and then assets, ink, js files, 404 template, 404.php. So like that, the code will be available like this. So if you want to, if you know the PHP, if you want to change any changes, you can do the changes if you know PHP coding. So archives, if you are, how you are getting archives, all those things, data by using this. So like this, and even comments. So for every functionality in the which is available in the website, so you will get the functionality, or you will get the particular that particular functionality will be work based on this code. When you write this code, then only that particular functionality is going to work. and then theme footer. See here, this is the footer code. So the footer we have seen, right? This one is footer, right? So that footer code is this one. Okay, this is the code of the footer. And then homepage code, this one. You can see. So if you are not a technical person, if you don't know any PHP or Java .NET, you don't need to worry. It's nothing. You don't need to do anything. Just I'm showing you this kind of code will be available in the editor. But if you don't know anything about coding, you just don't go to editor. Even if you remove this semicolon also, the website will lose some its identity and you may get many issues. So that's why you should not do any kind of changes here. See, and theme header. So they are asking to, oh, we have not yet saved it. Okay, theme header. This is the code related to theme header. See, and then main index template. And then single page. Search results. And then sidebar. So like this, you will have separate PHP files on particular every, for every functionality, they will maintain separate PHP files. So it's better to take, if you want to do any changes, so it's better to take any backup of this particular data. So template parts, readme.txt, demo content. So for demo content also, they will have this option. So, okay, so this is the editor. Just I am coming out of the editor option. And then this appearance part is completed. So just I'm clicking on the dashboard. So till now, we discussed posts, we discussed all posts also, we discussed add new categories, tags, in media also we discussed pages, how to create pages also we discussed, even comments also we discussed, in appearance, themes we discussed, customize also we discussed, widgets, menus, header, background, import demo data, and about magazine print editor. So also we discussed. So just we will see, before importing the demo data, just we will see plugins option also. So if you click on the public plugins, you will have installed plugins, add new and editor. So just click on the install plugins. So what are the installed plugins are available? Just you can see over here. So Akisman anti-spam, that means which is going to detect the any spam things comes, spam coming, sir, any hackers come to your website, and if they hack your website, so in order to protect the from the hackers, this Akisman anti-spam is going to, these are the defaultly, these were installed. So when you install the WordPress, so this Hello DALL-E and Akisman anti-spam, this will be installed automatically, but they will not be activated. You have to activate them. This one click demo import, we have activated right now. Just they ask you to install this particular one click demo import. So that's why we install this one. This is recommended by the particular theme. So this recommended by Magazine Prime. So some of the plugins will be recommended by the particular WordPress theme. So according to WordPress theme, some plugins will be different. So this will be imported by the, this will be recommended by the WordPress Magazine. And this one automatically installed when you install the WordPress. So used by millions, XAML is quite possibly the best way in the world to protect your blog from spam. So in order to protect from the spam, you have to install this one. So just you click on the activate button. So you don't worry, even we will discuss how to install the plugin also. You don't worry. So Hello Daily also, this is not just a plugin. It symbolizes the hope and enthusiasm of an entire generation summed up in two words, sung most famously by Louis Armstrong. Hello Dolly, when activated, you randomly see a lyric from Hello Dolly in upper right of admin screen on every page. So just we will see details. One plus million downloads are there. This is not just a plugin, same. See here, howdy option you are getting, right? So this is nothing but this particular, if you want to, if you install this one, you will get all these things upper right corner. So they are saying that Hello Dolly in the upper right of your admin screen on every page. This is the upper screen, right? Here you will get the this one. These are all not required, but if you install this, this one, nothing will happen. Activate. Just you will refresh. One of our world favorite songs from way back when. Okay. Leave it that one. Just we will go to, if you want to install any other plugin, so then click on the add new option. Same here also you can go, or you can click on this one also. I'm closing all those things. See here, you will get plenty of plugins are available. Some premium plugins are also available. You have to pay some money in order to get that particular plugins, and even you can get freely also. Some of the plugins will be freely, you will get also. So in order to what we asked, actually we have to import the demo data. So just click on the import data. So in order to import the demo data, we need one plugin. So that is nothing but, so importing demo data, post pages, emails, and theme settings is the easiest way to set up your theme. It will allow you to quickly edit everything instead of creating content from scratch. Okay, this one click demo import option of that particular theme, sorry, that particular plugin we already installed, right? So that's why it is showing you, it is giving you, just I will show you, installed plugins. We installed just now only. Here, see here, one click demo import. So we install it, that's why it is giving you option to import the demo data. Just we click on the import demo data. So it will be very easy to customize your website if you click on the, if you import the demo data, because the website will be filled with demo data, and you can simply change the, just change it. So it will look like the same how you have, how we have seen the that particular live demo, how we have seen. So like that only your website will appear. Magazine, what is the theme name? Magazine Prime. Magazine Prime. WordPress theme live demo. So how we see the live demo, so like that only you will get the this particular demo. Same, the data will be installed, the demo data will be installed, and you will see the full-fledged website. So then you can even do the changes also. Like that you will get. See here. So this is the demo website. See here. This total demo website you will get like this. So this is the demo. If you want to have the all the demo data, then you can choose the this demo data. Otherwise, you can create your own home page and your own particular page, and you can select and everything. You can do each and everything with the that. It's also even importing, so it takes some time. That's all done. The time the demo import has finished. Please check your page and make sure that everything has imported correctly. If it is, you can deactivate the one click demo plugin because it has done its job. So this one click demo import plugin is only for to import the this particular demo data. So this function, if after checking, just we'll do, we'll check the, see, you got all the demo data. See, even when you import the demo data, whatever the data you have just now, you have we have inserted some posts, we have inserted some categories, we have added some categories, we have added some posts, but they have not yet gone. See here. So entertainment is there, fashion, oh, they have gone, right? So entertainment we have not given. Tech news we have given, but some categories were changed, so no issue. We can even change again later. See here, we have this one we have posted yesterday, so this was not also not this was not deleted, but all the posts which are available in the particular now in that particular website, whatever the data is available, it will also add that data also, including this demo data. See, if you import the demo data, you will have a very easy task. You will get easily, you can get into this particular admin panel, and you can change simply whatever the changes you want to change. You can simply do the changes. Even this one is available, the particular logo and the description also available. So home, blog, economy, politics, even social icons also they are showing. So then you have to just link your social icons to this particular social pages to these particular links. So what they are saying, when you import the data, the following things might happen. No existing posts and pages, categories, images, custom post types or other data will be deleted or modified. So post pages, images, widgets, menus, and other theme settings will get imported. So please click on the import button only once and wait. It can take a couple of minutes. So our task is completed. So then what we will do, just go to plugins and click on the install plugins and then deactivate the one click demo import, because this task is completed. This particular plugin task is completed. When you don't want that particular plugin, you just click on the deactivate option. So if you don't, if you want to again activate, just click on the activate. If you want to delete that particular plugin for a lifetime, then you just click on the delete option. So this is the so if you want to add any plugin, so just click on the add new option. So we will add one plugin, that name is WP Super Catchy. This improves the performance of the website. So this is definitely, you need this kind of plugins, so in order to improve the performance of the website. So then what I will do, if you know the particular plugin name, you can just simply type here. If you don't know, just you can check, even you can check in the Google search engine, you will get the list of the plugins even here also. if you just click on the add new, you will get plenty of plugins, or you will get here. So just you can check and even you can add the plugins. If you know the plugin name, no issue. Just you can type the plugin name over here. So I typed WP Super Cache, and then I got the WP Super Cache, and then a very fast caching engine for WordPress that produces static HTML files. So it will improve the performance of your website. And the last updated, when it was updated 4 months ago, just a second. Whether it is compatible or not. So it is compatible with your version of WordPress, and how the ratings will be there. See here, 4.5 rating is there, and 1+ million active installs are there. So 1+ million, that means 10 lakhs above installations are there. And even you will have other plugins also, which will increase the performance of your website. Not only this one, but this is famous. So even you will have plenty of other plugins also will be available. See here, auto optimize is also a speeds of your website by optimizing JavaScript, CSS and HTML syncing, and JavaScript removing emoji craft, optimizing Google fonts and more. And this one is WP fastest cache. This means the simplest and the fastest WP cache system. And WP has hide login. This is related to some WP login or PHP to anything you want. Change this if you want to change any login credentials, then you can do this one. So what I discussed. So if you want to change any functionality, if you want to add any functionality to your website, so definitely you can use these plugins. So these are all the extra functionalities of your website. They will improve the performance and they will increase the extra functionality of that particular. You will get extra features. If you want to do some extra things in the website, then definitely you have to take the help of plugins. So that's why plugins are very, very important in the WordPress. So you have to know each and every plugin which you are using, and what is the feature of that particular, what is the use of that plugin, and each and everything you should know detailedly. Super static cache and 2000+ active installs. So even you have to see the installs also, how many people have installed that particular. Same when you buy any product in the online, so definitely you will see reviews also, you will see ratings, you will see, and then you are going to buy the product. So like that only, here also you have to check for the rating and review, and how many people have installed. Even Play Group also, in Google Play also, what you will do, you just before installing any app, you will check whether this app has good rating, whether this app has good reviews, and how many active installs are there on the particular app. So each and everything how you check. So like that only, on the same way you have to check here also. Here also you have to check. Just we will see. So these are all the plugins which are related to that's WP Super Cache. So just we will install this one only. So I want to install this one. So 1+ million active installations are there, and rating also is very good, and it is compatible. So just I'm clicking on the install now option. Okay, it was installed, and then click on the activate. Okay, so you just click on the installed plugins, then you will get the your WP Super Cache here. So very fast caching plugin for WordPress. So if you want to do some settings over here, just click on the setting on that particular plugin. What they are saying, a custom URL permalink such a required for this plugin to work. Please go to okay. So actually we have to do all the permalink structure, so we have not done, right? Okay, so after we have to do all those things. So here this is the concept of plugin. So we can install any kind of plugins over here. So actually we will do one thing. We will install one super plugin, that is Yoast SEO, which is related to SEO, it is used in the SEO. We will discuss that plugin in the SEO topic, but just we will discuss now. Just we will install that particular plugin now. Yoast SEO. This tab, regarding this Yoast SEO plugin, we will discuss in the while we were discussing search engine optimization. While we were discussing in the SEO, definitely we will discuss this Yoast SEO plugin. But just for understanding purpose, just I am installing this one. So see here, 20,467 people rated this particular Yoast SEO plugin as a number one plugin and 1+ million active installation. When it was updated, 1 week ago only it was updated, and even it was compatible with your version of WordPress. So like this, if you want to install any plugin, if you know the name of the plugin, just you can type the plugin name here, and then what it does, improve your WordPress SEO, write better content and have a fully optimized WordPress site using the Yoast SEO plugin. You just click on the install option. Okay, it was installed, but I'm not activating this one right now. So we will we will discuss regarding Yoast SEO plugin in the when we start discussion on the search engine optimization topic. Okay, so you can check even in the installed plugins also. You will get, see here, Yoast SEO. You discuss you already. Installed, but you are not yet activated. So if you want to activate, you can activate here. If you want to delete also, you can delete here. Okay, then we will move to users option. So what is this user? So if you are a company, if you maintain one company, so then in your company, if employees are there, some of the employees, for some of the employees, you have to give the access to this particular admin panel. So you are the admin of this particular website. So then you have to give options as an admin. Also, you can give some other people, you can allocate them as admin, or you can give them as editor or contributor, so that they can also post the items. They can also do some changes in the particular website. So in the cases, how to give the credentials to the other users. So those things we will discuss now. So just click on the all users. In the users, we have all users, add new and your profile. So just click on the all users. What you are getting? So you got only one user, because you are on the only admin while installing the WordPress. Only we have set up this admin account. So only one person is available. So what you want to do, you want to create one another, or you want to give credential to another person. So just here I'm clicking, but definitely username and email is required. So without username and email, you cannot give the particular details. What I'm doing here, just giving the username and giving email. First name, if you don't give name also, first name, last name also, nothing will happen. But just I'm giving. So what is your WordPress website? So those things you don't need to give. If you give also, nothing will happen. Password. So this is the password you get. So if you can't remember this password, just you can create your own password also. Confirm, this is a weak password they are saying, but for demo purpose we are giving, because I will not remember again. Okay, so confirm weak password. So if you want to send the new user, an email about their account. So if any new users officers are coming, then if you want them the details, if you want to send the details to the admin mail, so then click on the this particular checkbox. Here it is the important one. So role, what kind of role you want to provide this particular user? Either you want to provide subscriber, either you want to provide contributor, either you want to provide author, editor, or administrator. So like that, you have to give the these particular things. So either subscriber, contributor, author, editor, administrator. So what kind of role you want to provide? So administrator is the last person who has the all the access, who has all the particular credentials, has the all the access to the particular website. So if you give administrator, you can do each and everything in the particular websites. No, if you want to give them as a only just contributor, that means he can only write the articles and he can just post the articles. If you give contributor, he can just, we will see what will happen. Add new user. So Mahesh was added, and then just I will log out from this particular admin panel, and then I'm adding username and what is my password. Okay, I got the contributor. So I have given this Mahesh person was given as a contributor. So then that contributor can only add the post. So apart from that, he cannot do anything. See here, the options also are not visible to him. See here, no option is visible to him. Only post option is visible to him. Pages also he cannot create. He cannot do any, even appearance option also not coming. Settings option not coming. So no other option will be come to him. So as a contributor, he can only click on the all posts. He can see what are the posts are available, what are the posts were added, and then if he wants to add new post, then he click on the new post, and then he can add the particular post. So his duty is only to post the article. If any person is there, his duty is only to add the, only to import the data. So then he can be given as a contributor option. So if you give administrator, so if he do any changes, even accidentally or intentionally, if he does any changes in the particular editor, or if you do any changes to the theme options, any if he changes the theme, so we may lose the data. So if it is a important data we have in the website, so definitely accidentally or intentionally we may lose the data. So in order to remove, in order to avoid all those things, so they have provided you some options in order to get the all the in order to give the roles. So what they are giving you, see here, sorry, but you do not have the correct permissions to activate the one click demo import plugin. Please contact the administrator of this site for help. Something they are giving. So like that, you don't have any option in order to do any kind of thing. Just you can post the data, you can post the article as a contributor. Okay, just I'm logging from this particular, logging out of the particular admin panel, and I'm adding admin. Okay, click on the login. So just see here, click on the all users. You got two users. If you want to create another user, who is as a, just same, take another one. You don't need to give these names also, just give as a author or editor also. If you give editor, what will happen? Just we will see. See my H1, I have given is as a editor. So just I am logging out of that particular admin panel, and logging into Mahesh one. See here. So what he got as the editor, he can post the he can post the articles, and he can create the categories, even he can create the tags, he can even add the photos, even he can create the pages also, even he can show, he can see the particular comments also, he can see his own profile, he can see the tools. So that's it. But even as the editor also, he cannot see the appearance option, he cannot change the themes, he cannot change the background color, he cannot do the any changes, he cannot customize the website, and he cannot access the editor, and anything he cannot access. Just he can create the pages, and he can create the posts, and he can create the categories and tags. So this is the editor. So that's why, according to the levels, according to your employees, so you can give the levels for one by one, so then they can do their task. So like that you can give the options. So just I'm coming from out of this particular login admin. See here, so this is the concept of users. So you can see your own profile also, this one you can change, but username cannot be changed again. So you can change the first name, last name, nickname, display name publicly. How do you want to show your name in public? So your email, website, about yourself. If you want to give you any brief information about yourself, you can give as admin. And you can choose your profile pic also. So same account management, if you want to get new password, you can get the new password, and you can click on the update password, update profile, your details will be changed. So this is the concept of users. And then we go to tools. Just what is the tool? So just we click on the available tools option. See here, so the following recommended plugin is currently inactive. Begin active. This you don't know. So if you want to convert your categories to tags, use the categories and tags converter available from the import screen. So some tools, whenever if you want to do any changes in the website, some tools will be available by with the help of the tools only, you can do the some changes. So what they are giving available, what are the right now available tool is, if you want to convert your categories to tags, some categories we have already created, right? So on the categories, if I want to convert that categories to the tags, so tags, why tags are used, we already discussed this one in yesterday's class. Tags are used only for the internal linking purpose. We use that particular tag. So if you want to convert the categories into the tags, so that you can use this particular categories and tags converter, and you can convert the particular categories into tags, they are saying. So if you want to use, you can use. So these are all the available tools. So some tools will be available whenever you, if you require any particular task, if you have any task to do, or if you want to do any extra functionality, then you can simply use this some tools which are available in the tools option. So import means if you want to import any, just click on the import, see here. So if you have posts or comments in another system, WordPress can import those into this site. To get started, choose a system to import the below. So blogger, import post, comments and users from a blogger's blog. If you want to import, if you have some data in some other website or some blog or somewhere, so you want the whole data to import into your website. So then how you can import? So only by using this import option, you can import the all the data from the other external source. If you want to get the data from Blogger, then you have to install this particular Blogger, and then you can import the data from that particular Blogger. So if you want blog role, so this import links in OPRL format is not required. and categories and tags converter. If you want to convert the tags categories into tags, so this live journal, this we don't need moving type and type, but RSS feeds, if you want RSS feeds, you can import. And Tumblr, so this is a Tumblr is a another social media network. If you want to import the post and media from Tumblr, and we can use some API means application interface, that is nothing but application program interface. It's a that particular external application will have some API. They will give us their API, and then we can use that API and we can install the, we can import the data of the particular from their website. So even WordPress, if you want to import post, pages, comments, comment, custom fields, categories and tags from the WordPress export file, you can use this particular option. So like that, if you want to import anything from any external source, you can import the things from this option. If you want to export, so you have some data. So like this, just you will see when you click the button below, WordPress will create an XML file to save your computer. This format, which will be called WordPress extended RSS or XXR, will contain your posts, pages, comments, custom fields, categories and tags. So once you have saved the download file, you can use the import function in another WordPress installation to import the content from the site. So choose what you want to export. So if you want to export all the content, or if you want to export all the posts or all the pages or all the media, so whatever you want to export, just your, this will contain all your posts, pages, comments, custom fields or everything. So just we will check all the content I want to export. Just click on the download export file. So one export file in the form of XML will be downloaded. So this will be you will get this external file. So all the related to data which is available, which is from your website. And then if you want to import into any other website, just you can import into this another website by using the this import concept. And even we have some export import plugin also will be available. Even you can use that export import plugin also in order to export or import the data into website and vice versa. So this is the concept of tools. And then we left with settings. So we will also discuss the settings option, and then we will end up the session for today. So in settings, go to general. So click on the, we have general, writing, reading, discussion, media, permalinks, akismet, anti-spam, and WP super catch. So what are the general settings? Just we click on the general settings. See here. In the general settings, you get site title, what is the site title and what is the tagline and what is the WordPress address and what is the site address. So while installing the WordPress, what you have given, so this one you have given, and what is the actual site address, same, definitely WordPress address and site address will be same. And what is your email address and membership, this we don't require. And new user default role, when you want to give new user what is his default role you want to give, yes, you can select. And site language, of course, and time zone. So time zone UTC plus zero, okay. So it is showing you choose a choose either a city in the same time zone as you are a UTC time zone. So as a UTC time zone, UTC plus zero time zone is, and according to your time zone you can choose. Actually our time zone is GMT plus 530, right? So this is universal time zone. So universal time zone in India, yes, we will check. I also don't know. So UTC plus 530 in India and Sri Lanka. So in Hyderabad also, I think same. Today is 26th, right? OK, Okay, UTC plus 530 only, right? So just we will. Okay. UTC plus 530. So what is today date? April 26, 2018. If you want to any formats, date formats, just you can check this one or this one or this one. And the time format also you can check. Like this one or this one or this one. Or if you want to give any custom also, you can give. Just week starts on. Week starts on Sunday, right? Save changes. See, just we will go to website and we will see. See Thursday, April 26, 2018. So these are all the general settings. If you want to do any date related settings and everything, any site related settings, URL related settings, you can go here and you can do the changes. And this one is writing. So what is writing setting? So default first category, they are giving you one category. So if you want to change to default post category as any one of these, you can change. So default post format standard. If you want to change, you can change. So this is not required for us. You don't need to worry. This post via email and this update service also, you don't need to require. Just save on the save the changes. And then reading. Your homepage displays. How your homepage displays. If you want to displays here, your latest post, just click on the latest post. No, if you want to create a static page, if you have static page and if you want to create the static page, if you want to select the static page, just select the static page and then blog pages. So how many blog pages you want to show, and then how many you want to show recent items. So if you, for each article in your feed, if you want to show full text or summary, so search engine visibility. So if you want to select this one, the search engines will not index your site. So that we will discuss in later when we discuss on search engine optimization, we will discuss all those things. So click on the save changes and then discussion. So default article settings, append to notify blog links to from article, allow link notifications, people to post comments. If you want the comments, then click on the check the box. So other comments sections. So here, if you want to comment, author must fill out the name and email. So user must be registered and logged, or otherwise just by giving the name and email, he can comment or automatically close the comments on articles if you select the option. So enable threaded comments. So if on that particular comment, any other people can also comment on the comment. So like that, how many nested comments you will allow. So even you can give break comments into pages, like that also you can give. Even comments should be displayed with older comments on the top of the each page. So everything on this particular settings, you can do each and everything. And even email me whenever. So if you want to email on the particular anyone post on a comment, then if you want to get the email to, you will get the email on particular. If any young person comes to the website and if he comments on the particular article, then you will get the email on that particular comment. So like the each and every, if you want to do comment moderation also, you can do here. Hold a comment in a queue if it contains two or more links. So like that, a common characteristic of a comment spam is a large number of hyperlinks. So when a comment contains any one of these words, so you can actually when any abusive content are there, any like this, any URL, email or any IP address is there, then you can moderate the comment. So here we can see the all the moderation sections, and you can even block the comments. Any, if you get any abusive content, if they type any abusive content, or if they type any IP address or any other, some people will try to hack the website by using this comment section. So that's where we can do all those things by simply, in order to avoid all the hackers from our, avoiding them to hack the website. So we can do all those things, comment block list and everything. We will discuss these all those things later. No need to worry. And avatar. So this one. So in order to get your as a admin, if you want to get any like this, if you want to get your your avatar like this, or you if you want to get your blank or logo, if you want to get logo like this, you can do all those these changes and just click on the save changes. And even media, so like this one is media, so we already discussed it, so we can sizes. So when you want to do the changes of the thumbnail, actually default thumbnail size is 115 to 150. If you want to change the default thumbnail size, you can change here. So medium size 300 300. If you want to change the medium image size, you can change here. So in the media option, you can change. So large size is, this is the default size. If you want to change according to your requirement, you can change the sizes here. So and under our last one is permalink. So here this permalink is nothing but when you want to give the link. So when you type the website here, so when you click on the link, how you will get, see here, so you are getting like this. So actually permalink should be, it should be in the format of like this. So post name, so website name, and then you have to get post name, because you see, it's, if you give like this, then only it will be user friendly. Otherwise, this particular username, that particular link will not be user friendly. So why we have to select only post name, that we will discuss when we will discuss on the search engine optimization. Okay, just click on the save changes. Okay, this is the permalink. So then this anti-spam, when you want to protect your website against the spam, so then you have to activate the ask this on. Actually this is not required, so you don't need to worry about this. This is a plugin, extra plugin this is. And even the super cache also, if you want to increase the performance of your website, then you can choose this one. These are the some settings will be there. You have to set the settings, so and then you can increase the performance of the particular website. So these are super catchy, and this anti-spam are the plugins we have installed. Okay, that's why it is showing the, it is asking to set the settings. So this is the, all the options are available in the this particular admin panel. So from tomorrow we will discuss the next topics. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you.